The skids that Conestoga Log Cabins and Homes provides with each cabin kit are 4x6 pressure-treated beams. It is on these beams that we lay the floor and porch decking. You then build the cabin on top of the completed decking. The decking we provide with our buildings for our interior floor is 2x6 tongue and groove or T&G material. The porches can have a variety of materials, but standard is 2x6 pressure-treated deck boards. We also supply composite decking, among other options. The first important step in laying out the skid correctly is to make sure that you have a proper foundation. See the foundation section for more information about foundations. The most important aspect is that the foundation is level and square. Lay out the skids at the proper spacing. See the specific plans for the model you are building for these measurements. It's best to use the pressure-treated board provided. Measure and cut to the correct length. Fasten to the outside skids to keep the skids at the proper spacing when squaring the skids. After positioning the skids, make sure the skids are square to each other. You do this by measuring corner to corner in an X pattern. When the measurements are the same, you know the outside skids are square. Now is a good time to attach the skid to the foundation as required by local codes or specified on the supply drawings. This is also the time that electrical wires should be run, and underfloor insulation could be installed unless you have good access under the cabin to do it later. Now you are ready to attach the decking. Start at the back of the cabin floor and work your way forward. The first board used has the groove cut off of it to add extra stability to the wall that will sit on top of it. Fasten the T&G board down with the stainless steel screws provided. Screw from the top down on the board ends and blind screw in the middle skids. To do the best job possible, it's important to make sure the boards are tight. It's best to use a long pipe clamp to ensure that the boards are as tight as possible. This way, when they do shrink and expand as all wood floors do, you maintain a minimum amount of joint exposure. When you get to a point where electrical wire is to come up through the floor, mark the position on the T&G boards and drill a 1-inch hole. Pull the wire through the board and then fasten it into place. Continue to fasten down the T&G decking until you are less than 1 board width before you reach your final measurement for the interior floor. Fit, but do not fasten the last board in place, and measure to the correct interior floor measurement. Make a line using a long straight edge or a chalk line, and then rip the floorboard and fasten into place. Next, butt the pressure-treated deck boards against the inside flooring and fasten down into the skids from the top. For the nicest job, use a countersink bit to pre-drill the screw holes in the deck boards. When finished fastening the deck boards into place, measure 3 inches from each side skid. Make a line using a long straight edge or a chalk line, and then rip the ends of the board, producing a nice, even edge. Finally, place the protective metal trim on the sides and back of the inside floor. Secure the metal trim using the 1¼-inch cap nail with the plastic cap removed.